Hey guys, it's me Vikas and this is Weird Genius. Guys, today I'm with the episode that is like around GIT or Git version control system. So as you are, we might be familiar with Git, and for that, let's say you want to put a Git server on your local network or local LAN, you can just do it. And this episode is all about how to like make a local Git server for your local code repositories and all. So let's check it out, how to do it using Banobo Git server. So guys, this is the Banobo Git server website where you can download all the steps that is required to run the Git server on your Windows system. So let's check the prerequisites to install the Banobo Git server on Windows system. So head over to the install page, and over here go to the prerequisite page. So first is the ISS 7 for Windows. So to install ISS 7 on your Windows system, you can go to control panel, and over there just head over to programs, and over here go to turn Windows features on or off, and over here just select the IIS service. Over here the Internet Information Service, check this box and it automatically this check will be checked. So just leave it around and click on OK. So guys, this is actually for my Windows 7 system. This may change depending upon the operating system you are currently using. So after activation of IIS, you can simply navigate to your browser and type on localhost. And you will see a space something like IIS7 written over here. So that means we have successfully activated the IIS. So guys, the next prerequisite is the .NET framework 4.5. So actually I have just given a link down below, so you can download it directly. And over here actually I have already installed it. If you have not, just you can download the .NET framework 4.5 and you can install it. So so after installation of .NET framework, you will see something like this: Microsoft .NET framework 4.5.1 and all other things. So the next requirement is to install the ASP.NET MVC 4. I have just provided the link below, or you can follow this link and you can download it. So okay, let's download the MVC 4. You can just go to standalone MVC 4 installer and download it by clicking over here. So after completion of download, you should see something like this: ASP.NET MVC 4 setup.exe file. Just hit on OK, then click on I agree. Next is install it. Click on yes. So it will take some time to install, just wait for that. So after successful installation, click on close. Now it says to register the MVC framework with IIS. So to do that, simply copy this command. As I am on Windows 7, or if you are on Windows 8 or other, you can follow the description over here. Or on Windows 7, just simply copy this command Now open up the command prompt. With administrative privilege. So to do that, just click on run as administrator. And now just paste the command and hit enter. Okay, so this completes all our requirement to install the Bonobo Git server on our Windows system. So let's get back to the website. And over here, click on the download 5.2.0. So after download, you can see a file something like zip file. There is the version number written over here. After download, simply extract the file. Now, simply copy this extracted folder to your local disk C. Then over here you'll see a folder something like island pop, and over here wroot, and paste the folder over here. Click on continue. So after copying the files or the folder to the required folder, now next thing is to provide permission to the IIS user to modify the app data folder inside this extracted folder. So to do that, go to the app data folder over here, click on properties, and now go to like security, then browse the IIS users, click on edit. Click on edit and now just select this IIS users, and over here just hit on everything allowed. Click on apply. Okay, so that was all about like providing permission to the user. And now next thing is to make this particular Bonobo Git server into IIS application. To do that, open a command prompt. Tap on IIS manager. Do that. Click on like search for IIS manager and in the IIS manager, go to sites. And so now over here under default website, just like right click on 5.2. Actually this name depends upon the file name we have given inside your inet pop where you have copied your like Bonobo Git server files. So for me it's like 5.2. okay, so right click on 5.2, then click on convert to application, and over here make sure that you have selected ASP.NET before, then click on OK, again OK, and just select it and go to authentication, and you should see something like anonymous authentication enabled. If it is not enabled by default, make it enable by clicking over here. And then over here right now it is disabled only, but if it is actually disabled, then you will see something like enable. Now head over to your browser and type in localhost slash the folder name we have given. Like for me, it is 5.2. So everything has gone right, guys. So you should see something like this. Go ahead with username admin, password admin. So guys, after that you will see something like this. That means we have successfully installed our Bonobo Git server on our Windows system. Let's say you want to access it on a different computer, then you can type in the IP of the system you have installed on, then slash the folder, that is 5.2. So same thing, you can access it by using IP also. And over here you'll see the Git, like Git, various Git options, like create new repository, so group, all those things, like in create team. So guys, it's up to you to explore the different options available on the Bonobo Git server. That's all guys, thank you, thanks for watching.
Hey guys, it's me once again, and hope you have liked my video. If so, just hit the thumbs up button. If you don't, there's a thumbs down button for you also. And don't forget to subscribe my channel for latest updates. Okay, see you next time with my new content. That's all guys, thank you, thanks for watching.